both of them, they were doing the same thing. You see, that's why the enemy hates women with perfect hatred. Now, this man, the man who was with that woman, when these people caught her, where was the man? Who was the man? When they brought the man to Jesus, and when they brought the woman to Jesus, and Jesus looked at them and said, "You people, you think you are safe? If you know that you have not done anything, start throwing the stone. Start throwing the stone to this woman." And now, Jesus, when these people had so, then Jesus looked at the ground and lied down. And the woman was waiting to hear the stone coming to her. But after all, the men left, all of them went. Let the enemy, the devil, leave you and go. And leave you with Jesus. You have gone through hard time. Let the devil, the enemy, that has been following you, let him leave you. Let him go away completely and leave you with Jesus so that you can enjoy the life. And now when Jesus opened his eyes, look up and said, "Woman, where are they who brought you here? Where are they?" Then he said, "Woman, you are set free. You have been forgiven." So Jesus Christ has forgiven us all the curses which were put in the woman. Jesus Christ set us free and has forgiven us. And we need to be free from these curses that has been following women all over the world. All over the world, the women have been suffered so much. They have been tortured. The women have been ruled very badly. They don't even been recognized in some other cultures. Some cultures, they don't want a woman to talk. They say, "You woman, don't even, you have no voice." But we thank God for the women of the voice, other women who are raising up the voice for other women. I pray that God Almighty will bless the woman and deliver the women who have been suffering, who are under this bondage, who are still being influences of men, who men are sitting on them, that does not want the woman to raise up. I pray for the women all over the world, wherever, who are still under this bondage, because Jesus set the woman free. All from the accusers, from those people are accusing, all the time they are accusing woman, that the woman is the one who was doing this. And they don't want to touch the man. Why? Because the enemy hates the woman with the perfect hatred. Therefore, I pray to you, woman, in the name of Jesus Christ, let you be set free. Let your accuser go away from your life. In the name of Jesus, let any problem that you are facing, let it go away and leave you in the name of Jesus. Let the devil, the enemy, Satan, who is against you, let that power, let his power and his ways get away from you in Jesus' name. I pray for you, woman. I pray for you, what you are going through. You are the one who takes care of children. Sometimes a man would leave you with the kids and you suffer so much. But I pray that any woman who is going through this hard time, may God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob visit you. May God deliver you from the hands of your accuser. May God deliver you in the name of Jesus from the powers of darkness. May God, our Lord Jesus Christ, who set you free, may he come and deliver you in the name of Jesus. May you receive the deliverance of Jesus Christ that Jesus has given you free. When he said, "Woman, you are free. You have been forgiven. The accusers have gone because they hate you. They want you to die and leave the man." Now, because of that, Jesus set you free. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray, let the power that created heaven and earth, our God, Lord, because God who loves us, he cursed a woman and they said, "Okay, my curse, I'm removing it. I'm going to send Jesus Christ to deliver you, and you will not be under those curses." Jesus, we thank you in the name of Jesus. The powers of heaven that created heaven and earth fall upon the women. Let the woman be delivered. Let the woman to go free. Those have been going through hard time. Those have been going through hard labor, even giving birth. Those who are bringing and that are expecting their babies. Lord Almighty Father, let their baby come safely. Let the pain go. Let them not be struggled. Not to go to Sicilia. Not anyone who has been suffering. Not going to that labor. That the God cast the woman, said the woman will be gone through hard labor. because Jesus has forgiven us, let those women that gone to have their children free without going that hard labor. In the name of Jesus, Lord Jesus, help the woman, deliver them, my God, my Father. In the name of Jesus, Lord Almighty, King of Glory, the enemy who deceived the woman, still they are continuing deceiving woman. Let this enemy be destroyed. Let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Let the enemy go away from the woman. Let the woman, let the enemy leave the woman and go, because they accuse the woman and them they don't accuse themselves. Oh Lord, my Father, have mercy upon the woman in the name of Jesus Christ. My Father, I thank you. I give you all the glory. I give you all the honor. You are a wonderful God, mighty God, King of Glory, King of Kings. I thank you. I give you all the glory, Jesus. My God, I pray for the women in the name of Jesus Christ. This is the day the Lord you have made. We will be rejoiced and be glad in it. We pray that God Almighty protect our women wherever they are. Lord, my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, hallelujah, praise be the name of Jesus, King of Glory, King of Kings. Lord, I worship you, Lord. Jesus, I thank you. Lord, I give you all the glory. I give you all the honor in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I worship you. Lord, I thank you. I pray, Lord, let your power fall upon the women in the name of Jesus. Give the women wisdom. Give them knowledge in the name of Jesus. Oh, Lord, my Father, I am so happy when I hear the women have been leaders. When I hear the women, that the leaders and rulers, I thank God that the woman, now they have been set free by Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus, Lord, my Father, I pray for these women. We give them more wisdom, give them knowledge, because Jesus has set them free. Jesus has forgiven us every sin. That power, that the sin that we committed from the beginning because of ignorance, Lord Jesus has set us free, has forgiven us in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, my Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, I thank you for setting us free in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Lord, that you were able to deliver the woman from the hands of the enemy. This woman, when she was brought to Jesus, and they were ready to stone the woman, and Jesus asked those people, when he looked at them, he said, "You think you have never seen anything? If you think you have not done anything, start throwing a stone. Let that enemy that is still accusing woman, let them go away from your life. In the name of Jesus, oh God, my Father, Lord, I thank you, Jesus. Let them lose their power. Let them lose their direction. Let them lose and go back and revise anything that they are accusing against you, wherever they are putting in you. Let God Almighty, my Father, let God destroy them in the name of Jesus. God has given women power and authority to trample upon snakes and serpents, and nothing shall harm you. Woman, go ahead and do what you are supposed to do. Don't fear. In the name of Jesus, Jesus Christ has set free. Look at those people who are accusing women. They are still accusing women up to today, but Jesus has set a woman free. That's when you see they are arguing. But I thank the nation who honor women, who respect the women. But now, these women, Jesus set them free. And that's why we are free, free indeed. When the Son set you free, you are free. Jesus himself set us free. If you look at this woman, they could have stoned her and killed her. But Jesus looked at them and said, how long will you be continuing accusing the woman? Remember, when the man got in the Garden of Eden, when the man telling God that the woman you gave me, and now here, they are bringing a woman, not bring the man. Where was the man and who was the man? Women, ask this. The devil hates you with perfect hatred. In the name of Jesus, any power hates you, I command them to be destroyed in Jesus' name. Any power hates a woman, any power hates a woman, may the Lord, may the Lord of ages meet them and destroy them in the name of Jesus. May the Lord Jesus Christ fall upon them and destroy them in Jesus' name. Powers that is pointing the women, still under oppressing woman, let this power be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I pray, God Almighty, Lord Jesus himself said in Luke 23, verse 27, when he said that women, cry to your children, cry to yourself and your children. Because Jesus said, although I deliver women and I forgive them, but I've seen still women will cry. There will be a lot of problem to the women. So the women, Jesus told them, cry for yourself and your children. Let us cry to ourselves so that God can have mercy upon us. God Almighty is God who is full of mercy and forgive us, and we pray for our children. Women, let us pray for our children. Let us cry to our life and pray for our children. God, my Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for our children, and we pray that God Almighty deliver our children wherever they are, oh God, my Father. What the children are going through right now, God, we pray that God touch them and deliver them, oh God, my Father. Deliver our youths, deliver our children, my Father, my Lord, in the name of Jesus. You know, if your children, even if they are older, they are 70, 90 years, they are still your children. That's why God is calling, pray for your children. Women, pray, mothers, pray for your children. Let us pray for our children in the name of Jesus. You know, the enemy is always accusing us and hate us perfect. You know, because women were more who were following, and the men didn't care. The men, they don't have sympathy. They were laughing and mocking Jesus. No woman, no, the Bible said when Jesus was being taken, was carrying the cross, no woman who mocked Jesus. I thank women, because there was no woman who opened up her mouth to Jesus. Now, the men were the one who mocking Jesus, spit on Jesus, and the women were crying. That's why the Bible says, Jesus looked at the women and said, women, I'm sorry for you. I'm sincerely sorry for you. But the truth is that cry to yourself and cry to your children. Don't cry to me. Me, I'm your deliverer. I'm one to fight for you. You will never be like this all the time. Let God arise and let enemies of women be scattered in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Lord, we praise your name. We pray that God protect the woman. Protect the woman from the accusers. Protect the woman from those people who are accusing women. Protect the woman from those who are raping women. Oh God, my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, my Father, children, a girl child who've been being tortured, who've been raped, who've been used in a wrong way, Father, protect them. She will become a woman. And Lord, I pray for the woman in the name of Jesus Christ. My God, in the name of Jesus, protect them. Protect them, God. Heal them, God, my Father. Heal them wherever they are. The cancer, breast cancer, my God, heal their cancer in the name of Jesus. Any woman who's suffering from cancer, who's suffering from the cancer, breast cancer, I command that cancer to be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I melt that cancer. I command the blood of Jesus Christ to touch this woman and heal this woman in Jesus' name. Why did the cancer go to the woman's breast? The breast, because the breast is the breast that the baby suck, and that's why the enemy wants to put you in that terrible pain. The enemy hates you so perfect. And in the name of Jesus, I command the enemy that hates women to be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I command that cancer in your breast to be melted in the name of Jesus. I pray that God Almighty set the woman free, because Jesus will forgive us. You said, let the woman free. And God Almighty, you are Jesus Christ, the Son of God, who loves women. You tried your best to show the world that you love women. In the name of Jesus Christ, since you love women, let that love continue into the life of the women. Let that love continue even to the labor where the woman is giving birth. In the name of Jesus, when the women are calling upon you, God answer you. Answer them, my God, my Father. When they are praying for their children, answer them, God, my Father. In the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, I thank you. Jesus, I give you the glory. In the name of Jesus Christ, oh Lord, my Father, I give you thanks. I give you honor. I give you all the glory. In the name of Jesus Christ, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name, I pray. Thank you very much for those who have joined me. May God bless you. I told you this topic is a huge one, so we'll continue another time, and then you will see why we need to empower women, why we need women to be empowered by other women, so that we can see that God, who has forgiven us, has still loved the woman, and the woman can.